I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to front only the essential facts of life and see if I could not learn what it had to teach. Henry David Thoreau was acutely aware of all that can be learned by a simple walk in the woods. And at the Hubbard Brook Experimental Forest in Woodstock, they are constantly learning from the woods.
Well, today is Monday, and for the past almost 18 years, I've come out in this forest every Monday, all kinds of weather, even in the rain, to collect the routine stream and chemist precip samples for the long-term record here at Hubbard Brook.
Hubbard Brook was established in 1955 by the U.S. Forest Service and is one of the most studied forests in the Northeast.
Data is collected on like a 15-minute basis, but we come out here and we have to check the instruments and make sure they're all up to speed and they're still working.
I love being able to keep my finger on the pulse of the forest and seeing the subtle and the great changes.
Here, the data tells the story, and the work is part of the research that's constantly being gathered and studied at the world-renowned forest.
People recognize the name Hubbard Brook all over the world.
The experimental forest is comprised of approximately 7,900 acres within the White Mountain National Forest, dedicated solely to learning more about our forest ecosystem.
The long-term monitoring is really the heart and soul of what we do here at Hubbard Brook. It provides a foundation for the long-term record. And I think we all know that ecosystems change very slowly. And it's the long-term record that allows us to see this change. I like to think of it as we make the unseen seen or the imperceptible perceptible.
The pioneering watershed experiments done here led to the discovery of acid rain. Hundreds of experiments are conducted daily in the forest, spanning all seasons.
On any one day, we might collect 30,000 data points. In any one year, we collect upwards of 50 million, 60 million data points. I like to kind of imagine data just flying through the air.
As the site manager at Hubbard Brook, Ian Helm is in charge of making sure all that data keeps flowing.
Every morning we come in and we look at our real-time computer and make sure all the data is streaming well and there aren't any sensors that are giving us problems or loggers or batteries that are dead. Bad data is way worse than no data.
Ian is also in charge of finding room for everyone to work.
I'm the go-to person when somebody wants to do research on bats or streams or salamanders. They'll come to me and then we'll figure out where in the forest that can happen without overlapping with other people's work. You know, the craziest one I'm sure you heard about is our ice storm experiment where we actually sprayed water in the woods when it was sub-zero and we created an ice storm and we made trees break. And it was really, you know, that's one of the fun things about my job is helping design these experiments.
The ice storm is one of many extreme climate event experiments that test everything from frozen soil to rainfall.
I'm standing in front of the Hubbard Brook Experimental Forest Drought Net Experiment. So the Drought Net Experiment is actually removing 50% of the incoming precipitation, and this mimics a 1-in-100-year drought.
Scott Bailey is a research geologist and has been working at Hubbard Brook for 22 years.
Some of the things that we do around here are more or less the same things that have been done since 1955. the long-term record and the fact that we've been able to sort of keep track of the pulse of the forest through the water as it's moving through it is really unique. So we have the longest record of rain and snow chemistry in the world, and one of the longest records of stream chemistry in the world.
That record is accessible to new scientific experiments and studies thanks to the physical archive housed on site with over 25,000 water samples and 25,000 wood and soil samples.
So what you're looking at here is actually water samples that were collected at the Hubbard Brook Experimental Forest as far back as 1967.
The hardworking team at Hubbard Brook takes pride in what they do, and they feel strongly about passing their knowledge on to the next generation of scientists.
I think Hubbard Brook, past, present, and next gen going into the future is just a tremendous community of scientists and learners.
They want everyone to know that they're keeping watch.
I would hope that our neighbors, both locally and regionally, you know, have kind of that peace of mind that we're up here in the forest, and we're slowly and carefully and meticulously monitoring the health of the forest ecosystems and on the alert for threats kind of now and in the future. We do have power, you know, through solid science, through communicating our science, and through passing that on to our policymakers to make a difference. And we did that here at Hubbard Brook.